Hi guys, and welcome to another Divi video. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Well, we've been taking a look at this great free plugin. It's called Divi Brain Add-ons, and like I say, it's absolutely free. You can download it from here. I'll put this URL down below the video. Hit the download free button to download it. And it adds 20 or so modules, and there's some great little modules here for a free plugin that is really good. And also, they've got a premium version. It's still in the beta state right now, but like I say, we're using the free version today, and there's some great little modules there. So I threw this little page together just testing out stuff. We've got a news ticker up there, which we'll be working on today, a divider, a couple of dual buttons, some really interesting cards. Scroll images, image carousels, I've got a vertical one there, comparison images, stat bars, interesting looking numbers there. We've got some people modules, it's one of my favorites there, we've just done a video about that. Testimonials, little info cards, video cards, and nice little review boxes right here, and that's great for your e-commerce site if you've got one. But like I say, we're going to work with the ticker today and see how this is going. And this is a great little feature to have on your site. It's actually working off our posts, so if I hover over it, it's going to stop. If I click on one of these titles, it's going to take us to that particular post. And there it is, Hello World. I bet you've never seen that before. Okay, well, let's start again. Let's start a new page. And we'll call it ticker. Obviously, I'm going to use the Divi Builder. I'm going to build from scratch. I'm going to put in a single column, single row for this today. Divi comes standard with all the light gray modules right here. And there's plenty more of them down the bottom here, just about enough to build any type of site. When you add the brain add-ons, it gives you these sort of purpley blue ones here, and there's some great additions, like I said earlier. And I'm looking for the ticker today. There it is, brain news ticker. And there we go. As you can see, it's put in a title, breaking news. And here are our little ticker feeds coming on here. Now, what you've got to remember, these little ticker feeds right here are actually your posts and your post titles. If we look down here, we can include certain categories. I've created a category called ticker. And if you go to your posts, here we are. Here's the names. And you don't have to put any content in here for the slider, or for the news ticker, I should say. You can just create a new post. Don't even have to use the builder. We'll call it whatever you want to call your title or your ticker right there. Let's give it a capital. Simply publish it. And go back to our posts. And let's just refresh. There's that new entry there. Hit the quick edit, give it the category that you want. I'm going to put mine in ticker right there. Update it. That's all you need to do to add a new little ticker here. Okay. So we put it in there and it's starting to scroll across with our little items. Let's go in there and adjust some of the settings here. Now mine was full width. If you want yours full width, you can have it anywhere you want on a column or a row. I'm going to make my row full width to make this full width. So I'm going to go into the row, the green tab right there, to design, sizing. I'm going to make the width 100%. I'm going to copy that, Control C, paste it in the max width below, or you can type it in, whatever you prefer. As you can see, we've got a full width section right there. Okay, to make this a bit more interesting, let's go in and start styling this a little bit now. Content, there's the title. You can use the title or not if you want to. I'm going to take that off. We'll just have a little bar going across. Here's the categories you want to include in your ticker. And like I demonstrated before, you can just create posts with a title and give categories and show different news at different times if you want to do that. You can order by date or title alphabetically, ascending, sorted by news limit 5. Let's make mine 8. I don't think I've got any more on that on there. Let's go down to our settings just below there. Moving speed is the time it takes to get from this point to this point across the whole of the screen, or however far you've got yours. And it's set to 30 seconds, 30,000 milliseconds, which is 30 seconds. For me, that's fine. You can speed it up by making it shorter or slow it down by making it longer. Spacing is obviously the spacing between each item there. You can have it going the other way if you prefer. I'm quite good with that left to right, as we tend to read from left to right. I think that works for me. You can put a bullet before the icon if you want to. I'm happy not to have one. And I like the pause on hover. That way they can sort of pause and get it. But if you're just doing titles rather than posts, you might want to turn that off so that they're not really wanting to click on it because it's moving. But that's entirely up to you. I'll leave mine on. Now a link is for the actual whole module right here. If they were to click anywhere that wasn't one of these links right here, this is where you'd put your link if you wanted to take them somewhere. If it's on your own site, obviously leave it in your same window. If you're linking to an external site, put it in a new tab so that your website stays open. Okay, well, we can give it a background if we want to. I think I gave mine a gradient last time. And I think I gave the top color red and the bottom color black. Let's give it a bit of depth there. Can't really see our writing, but we'll fix that in a minute in the styling. I'm going to leave it as linear from top to bottom. You can do radial if you prefer, and you can change gradient directions here like any gradient. We've got no background image, so there's no need for us to use this button right here. So let's move on to our design tab. We're not using a title, so we don't need to style it, and same with the text, but we are. The news text is the stuff that's scrolling across. So I want to make that so we can see it. I'm going to make it white. There we go. Now you can have a nice little skinny line like that. Or you can make it a lot fatter if you want with spacing. Now let's make our font weight say semi-bold. I'm not going to change the actual font style. You can make it uppercase if you want to make it more dramatic. Divi comes with hundreds and hundreds of font styles, literally hundreds and hundreds. And if you go in there, you just hover over one, it'll show you an example of what that font's going to look like. But I'm happy to leave mine on the default for the time being. That's fine. So we got that taken care of. Let's make it a little bit bigger. Let's make it say 25 pixels or something like that. There we go. You're not going to miss that. Letter spacing is fine. If you wanted to draw it out a little bit more, you could do that. But I'm happy to have it at the default setting. Line height is the space above and below. You can kind of do your padding with that if you want to. Not going to add any text shadow. We've got that dark color on the bottom, so it's not going to stand out. Don't think I want to put a border on there. And I don't think I want to put any box shadow on there. Let's go back into our spacing, and if you wanted to make it taller or fatter, if you will, top and bottom, you can just add some padding. And it doesn't have to be linear. You can have padding on the top and not on the bottom if you want to. Just put in the number, it'll put in the pics for you, and hit the chain, it'll do the bottom half for you as well. That's a little overkill for me. I'm going to change mine to about 20, I think. There we go, that works. And that's pretty much it, really. You know how to change the timing. We've got our hover on. It's going to take you to actual posts. But I'm just using it as titles, so there's no real content there. So let's save this. We'll exit the Visual Builder and see what we've got. Let's exit. And there we have it. There's our great little news ticker. I'm really pleased with that. That's going to get people's eyeballs on it pretty quick, which is what you want for your websites. So once again, we've been using the free Brain add-ons plugin today, and the link will be below the video. I hope you've enjoyed this today and found it useful. If you have, please give it a thumbs up, ring the bell, comment, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and WebDesignAndTechTips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.